Welcome to today's Grow It Green. We are at Sanborn Mills Farm in Loudoun. I'm joined by Sean O'Brien with UNH Cooperative Extension. Sean, we're here to talk about the beech tree today. Very common species here in New England, but it is kind of coming under attack by some disease right now. Can you talk to us about that?
So beech trees have in the past been susceptible to beech bark disease, and that's been with us for quite a long time. Mm-hmm. But now what we're seeing since about 2012, it started in Ohio, we're seeing something called beech leaf disease. And this is caused by a nematode that lives in the leaves of the tree, and it feeds on the tree leaves itself. And nematodes are, you might have heard of them, there are some that are beneficial and some that are not so beneficial, like this one. They're a microscopic roundworm that's hard to see. You really need a microscope to see it. And it feeds on the leaves of the beech tree, and it will cause this striping that you can see in the leaf. It causes this like kind of puckering of the leaf, and eventually the leaf itself will shrivel up and fall off of your trees.
Is there any way that we know of right now that can potentially stop or even slow the spread of this disease?
Right now, not really. We can spot treat individual trees, ones that have high ornamental value to you. But for forests, there isn't a really cost-effective method right now, no.
And when the leaves start to fall in the colder season, what should you do if you know that your tree is infected? Is this something that I can just throw into my compost, or do I need to take some other action?
Well, these leaves, once they're infected, they will fall before they would normally fall in the fall. And if that does happen, if you start to notice your leaves falling off of your tree, do not compost them, because that could spread the nematode to other trees. I would recommend either landfilling these, throw these in the trash. You can bury them or you can burn them. Those are kind of the best methods to deal with them.
All right, good advice there. Sean O'Brien from UNH Cooperative Extension, thanks for joining us today. And now we'll know what to look for in case our trees happen to come down with this disease. That'll do it for today's Grow It Green.